from
EDF Energy.
I'm Brad Lascarbo.
And I'm Hal Butchgrass.
Seeing some mind-bending, pants-ripping, jaw-dropping soccer action.
Okay, I trust you've got yourself in a comfy chair. You've taken ownership of the remote control and stocked up on provisions. Welcome to Germany, where the latest chapter in this glorious tournament is about to be written. Let the memories begin. Over the next month, we'll bring you all the action, all the goals, all the colour of the greatest show on earth. We'll bring you daily updates from the England camp, where Sports Reporter of the Year Gabriel Clark is embedded with Sven's squad. England have trained today in Frankfurt ahead of their opening fixture against Paraguay, and Gabriel will bring us his first report in a few minutes' time. Now, from what we're hearing, England fans back home have really caught World Cup fever. The flags are out, the beers have been chilled, and everyone's ready. Steve Ryder's at Silverstone for this weekend's British Grand Prix. Has the World Cup caught the imagination there, Steve?
Well, I know you're right in the thick of things there, Gabby, but I reckon Silverstone's going to be one of the best World Cup venues this coming weekend. We're going to have temperatures in the 80s, we'll have hot dogs and beer, we'll have England on those giant screens, we'll have a very partisan crowd as well, and for a few magic moments this afternoon, it became Formula One chop here, and Michael Schumacher, for one, was mighty relieved and in the end mighty impressed with the way Germany survived Costa Rica. It's going to be great fun here tomorrow afternoon, but we've got the serious business of British Grand pre-qualifying to come first of all.
Thanks, Steve. Well, Germany's been transformed into one big street party for the duration of the World Cup. The opening game has already been played, the hosts taking on Group A opponents, Costa Rica. Jim Rosenthal watched the match with the fans in Dortmund, and we'll hear from him shortly and show you the best of the action. Here in Gelsenkirchen for tonight's match between Poland and Ecuador are three of the top names in the game. Ruud Gullit, who lifted the European Championship trophy here in Germany for his beloved Holland. The dreadlocked Ruud there. Stuart Pearce, does anybody love the three lions of England more than this man? And big Sam Allardyce, passionate, proud, always outspoken. He wanted to be England boss. But we signed him up instead. Delighted to have all three of you here. Ruud, I imagine being back in Germany for a major tournament brings back brilliant memories for you.
Yeah, I think to beat Germany in Germany and then also lifting the trophy 3 or 4 days later was, I think, the biggest achievement of Holland. And I'm still particularly proud of that moment.
And excited to be here for a World Cup.
Yes,
they're going to do it well, aren't they?
Yeah, I think it's going to be an exciting tournament. We also expect a lot of Holland. Of course, it's going to be difficult, but Van Basten did well in the qualification matches, so we all look forward to the first start of Holland.
Stuart, of course, involved in arguably the most successful World Cup England side since 66. What was it like going into that tournament with England? Did you realise that you were going to do so well? Did you feel that?
I think the main thing was apprehension. I seem to remember, you know, going into it, we weren't sure how good we were, and then just a momentum built up amongst us. You know, we had the Dutch in our group stage from the offset, and we gained the momentum and come away with some credit, even though we thought at the time we could have come home and actually won it.
Sam, such a huge England fan, almost got that job. What are your greatest World Cup memories?
Well, I'm old enough to remember way back when 66 was about. I was 11 or 12 then, and that was a fantastic memory for me to remember it so vividly now, particularly the Jeff Hurst goal, the last one, you know, and England winning it, and the passion in our house at the time.
We need to update your memories a little bit, don't we? Let's see if we can do that over the next 5 weeks. Well, host Germany kicked off the tournament earlier. They played Costa Rica in Munich, but Jim Rosenthal watched the match with the fans.
I am in Dortmund, ahead of ITV's next big live game, 4:30 tomorrow afternoon. Trinidad and Tobago against Sweden, both in line to face England. And at last, some of the English World Cup fever has arrived. The restrained Germans have caught on to the fact that their team are about to launch their campaign. Here's the very best action from Munich with your commentator, Peter Drury.